students. Have a lovely day to all of you. Welcome to Easy Learning Channel. In this presentation, we are going to discuss about refraction of light through a rectangular glass slab and lateral displacement. Let us start. First, let us start with what is a glass block or a rectangular glass slab. It is a picture of a glass slab and it is transparent. And it is an object made of glass having cuboid shape, means three dimensionalities. Glass slab is a parallel sided medium and it is a transparent medium, so light can pass through it, and opposite sides are equal. That's all about glass slab or rectangular glass block. Now let us discuss what will happen when a light ray incident on the glass slab. It is a glass slab. Outside glass slab, air is a medium. And it is a normal drawn to the surface of separation of two medium. Consider a ray of light obliquely incident on the glass slab. And angle between normal and the incident ray is angle of incidence. And if there is no glass slab, means this is the actual path of the light ray. But here there is a medium change from air to glass. That means rarer medium to denser medium. So the light ray speeds down and bend towards the normal. Then the angle between the refracted ray, this is a refracted ray, and the normal is angle of refraction. And this refracted ray again incident on the down surface of the glass slab. And this is the normal drawn to that surface. And here the angle of incidence is angle of refraction only, because alternate opposite angles are same. This angle and this angle is same. From glass to air, again there is a medium change from denser to rarer medium. In this case, the ray of light speeds up. In rarer medium, light ray increases its speed. So it bends away from the normal. And this ray is called emergent ray because it is emerging out to the same medium, air. It starts from air and it emerges out to the same medium, air. And this ray is called an emergent ray. And the angle between the emergent ray and the normal is called an angle of emergence. This is the incident ray. This is a refracted ray. This is the emergent ray. And look here. It is the incident ray produced forward. And this incident ray and the emergent ray is parallel to each other because the glass slab, both the sides are parallel. So this incident ray and the emergent ray also parallel to each other. And that means the incident ray is parallelly shifting towards the emergent ray. That means there is a parallel shift from the actual path. This parallel shift or lateral shift from the actual path is called a lateral displacement. And we can say that lateral displacement is the perpendicular distance between the incident ray produced and emergent ray is called a lateral displacement. That means this distance, the shortest distance between the incident ray produced and the emergent ray is called a lateral displacement. Next is factors depends on lateral displacement. First factor is thickness T. It is the thickness of the glass slab. And thickness increasing means lateral displacement also increasing. Thickness of the glass slab increasing means lateral displacement also will increase. And if thickness is decreasing means lateral displacement also will decrease. So there is a direct relationship between thickness and lateral displacement. Second factor is angle of incidence. If angle of incidence increasing means lateral displacement also increasing. According to the angle of incidence, all other angles also will increase and the lateral displacement also will increase. So angle of incidence and the lateral displacement also directly related, directly proportional. And third is refractive index. Refractive index means optical density of the medium. Optical density increasing means the ray of light bent more towards the normal and the lateral displacement also will increase. So refractive index also directly related with the lateral displacement. And the next case, fourth one is not directly related. Wavelength is decreasing means lateral displacement is increasing. Wavelength decreasing only lateral displacement will increase. That means inverse relationship. And violet color is having the wavelength less and lateral displacement is more for violet color. And red color is having more wavelength, so lateral displacement is less for red color. And wavelength and refractive index is inversely proportional to each other. And these are the four factors. First three factors, thickness, angle of incidence and refractive index is directly proportional to lateral displacement. But the last factor, that is the only factor inversely proportional to lateral displacement, that is wavelength or color. And violet color is having more lateral displacement and red color is having least lateral displacement. Hope it is clear. Next, we are going to prove angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. Angle of incidence and angle of emergence is in the same medium, air. And let us prove that. First case, the light ray is traveling from air to glass. According to Snell's law, the refractive index of glass with respect to air, that means the refractive index of glass, refracted ray is here inside the glass. So refractive index of glass with respect to air is sin I by sin r. Sin I, this is the angle of incidence, and r, this is the angle of refraction. And in the second case, light ray is traveling from glass to air. In this case, angle of incidence is r and angle of refraction is e, that is angle of emergence. Let us see refractive index of air here, air with respect to glass. is sine R by sine E. And multiply both the equations together, we will get refractive index of glass with respect to air into refractive index of air with respect to glass is equal to sine I by sine R into sine R by sine E. Sine R cancel, and we will get sine I by sine E. And according to principle of reversibility, we know that the product of refractive index of two medium is equal to 1. In this case, the product of refractive index of glass with respect to air into the refractive index of air with respect to glass is equal to 1. So from this equation we can write sine I is equal to sine E. Let us consider sine 30. Sine 30 means is equal to sine 30 only. That means angle I is equal to angle E. That means in the case of glass slab, angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. Hope the topic lateral displacement is very clear to you, and you enjoyed the presentation. Stay connected. I will be uploading more videos. Thank you.